Now, I left you sitting on this report design. We can go ahead and close that because we're going to be replacing it. Incidentally, I don't know why this comes up blue. I haven't had a chance to investigate why it does that. And actually, I don't mind it. I usually copy the blue to the other section, so we'll go through that. It's a nice background. So let's close this and not save it. And then we'll go back up to create for a third time, back to the report section. We've done these two things here. I want to do the report wizard. Now, report wizard, it would give us a selection of tables. We only have the one table, so that makes that easy. And it shows all the fields in the selected table. And I don't want to pick all of them. Let's just pick last name. I'll click on last name and click this right pointing arrow. So that's how you put it in this selected fields box. An easier way to do that is just to double click. So let's double click on order number. And let's see, last name, order date. We want that. How about the product name, unit price, quantity? And I've got everything in there. That's all I need. So let's click on next. Now, one of the most powerful things about the reports is how they do subtotals and grouping and sorting. I'm going to skip that for right now, and we'll do it on the report itself. So for now, just click next. Here we have an initial sort, and I do want to use this. This, if I pull it down, has all the fields again. And this is an order report for August, so I want it primarily organized by date. But then within each date, since I've got more than one line on some orders, I want to make sure that all those order lines are together. So the second sort would be order number. And I've got that abbreviated ordno. So those two, and then click on next. I never use anything but this middle layout. The columnar and the justified make a total mess out of the report. They kind of stack things up, and I don't know, I can't imagine a time when I would use those. Notice this is nice down here, this check mark, adjust the field width so all the fields fit on a page. So we'll leave that there and click next. And so it's got the table name as the title, and I'll leave that. And then it wants to know, do we want to do print preview or do the design? And I'll just leave it in preview and click finish. So there's our report. So you can see it's got our table name as a title. It's got order date. It's sorted by order date. And we can see, like with this 4902 down here, when the date is the same, it's sorted by the order number, so that's good. Needs some work. You know, this product name is way too wide, but it just kind of made it wider to fit all the way across. So let's do this. Let's go to design on this report. Notice up on the top on the menu, it says close print preview. I'm going to do that, and that will leave us in design, report design. So here we're in report design. It does have a list of all the fields in case we want to put more in. And we can bring that back anytime. So for right now, I'm just going to close that by clicking the X here. Now, notice this has the same stuff that that report design had. Here's a report header. Here's a page header, a detail, and a page footer. And then there's a report footer, but it's been collapsed down to nothing. So if this August 2014 orders is the report header, that must mean that this is only going to occur once on the top of the report. These little titles here, order date, order number, must occur on every page. So let's check that out. If you want to go back to print preview, on the left side here, you can click this pull down, and print preview is one of the selections. So here's the report header. We found that was the report header. I'm going to click on the, there's a navigation button down here, kind of like the record navigator in the bottom of a table. But notice it says page. So here I can click on the right pointing arrow. So I'm on the top of the second page, and sure enough, that report header is not there. Only the page header is there. I can incidentally click on the last page just to see how many pages are on this report. So I've got 10 pages. And if I scroll down, okay, it ends about 3/4 of the way down, and here's the page footer on the bottom. So let's go back to design. Click on Close Print Preview. While we're back in design, notice that there is a whole bunch of report design tools. There's actually 4 menu selections, and for each one of these, we're going to have a ribbon. So that's quite a few tools we've got. Let's click on the one on the right, Page Setup. And notice margins is one of the selections here. I'm going to click on margins. This is one of the things I like about this wizard. It automatically picks narrow margins. Most printers, the minimum you can have for a margin is 1/4 inch. So that gives you the maximum area to make your report. So 1/4 inch around, like I mentioned, is 1/2 inch. And so it's already, if you'll notice out here, done the calculation and made this 8 inches wide. So what we'll do in the next lecture is we'll start looking at what these things are that are in these headers and footers and the detail, and how we can start manipulating them. See you in the next lecture.